welcome to the channel for the first time viewers. Welcome back for my existing subscribers. This is going to be an interesting one. Just going to cover some news, try this video format out. All right. So the first bit of news I want to talk about is this Battlefield 2042 cheat situation. So the game isn't even out yet. We just finished the tech test and waiting for the open beta or the closed beta if you want that early access or whatever the case may be, right? We're waiting to see what the beta has in store for us, and we find out that the game already has cheats. So there's already cheat websites, and according to Tom Henderson, who, when I watch a lot of these, you know, early content videos and things like that, he's a prominent name in that whole sphere. He's talking about, you know, that game is messed up. There's been a 400% rise in website traffic and signups in August, in August over July. And to me, that just screams that this game better have really good anti-cheat, because my hopes were that, you know, getting away from the cheaters inside of Warzone and moving over to Battlefield would be the play. But if this game becomes plagued by cheaters, it's going to be a little different, right? So obviously, the way the game plays Battlefield versus Call of Duty and Warzone, there's a lot of destruction, there's way bigger maps. I think it'll have not less of an impact unless they're just like out of control cheating, right? Like sniping you from your spawn, which I've seen in Battlefield 4. I've seen it where you can't get out of your spawn because every time you spawn, somebody in like some crazy roof just automatically headshots you, and it goes like 128-0. But that's very rare, right? So my hope is that they kind of get this under wraps, find out who's providing the cheats. I would even say go as far as, which I would hope that EA would do that, sign up for the cheats themselves and then either reverse engineer whatever they're reverse engineering their game to be able to access these codes. My hypothesis is that, you know, this is stemming from that leak of FIFA 21 over the summer, right? So over the summer, FIFA 21 had its game code leak and the Frostbite engine, which is also the engine that powers Battlefield, Madden. So any of those games, if they got down to the nitty gritty and were able to actually figure it out, they'd be able to create hacks and leaks, or not leaks, but hacks and cheats for those particular games that run on that engine. So again, hopefully they get this under control, but it doesn't look like they're going to. But I can't speak for it. I mean, I haven't even played the beta yet, so it's like, we just gotta wait and see. If we already see hacks in the beta, then we'll have a really good idea as to what's going on when the actual game launches. And I'm just hoping they don't ruin the experience for everybody, because my guess is that there's gonna be already, you know, its own uphill battle that they're gonna have to face. Now, the second thing I wanna talk about is GPUs, right? So I'm gonna talk about graphics cards. So when it comes to GPUs, it's been this wild story ever since last September. No one's been able to get one unless you were able to buy one. Luckily, there's been some ways that you can increase your luck, like for instance, going through and setting up automatic payments or Apple Pay so that you can quickly check out on Newegg or Amazon or wherever these things come available. But that still hasn't yielded results to everybody. Some people are still looking. Best Buy had a gigantic restock, and somehow people were able to get these cards and just flip them right back online. It's kind of the thing to do now, right? So people are seeing that I can make a couple hundred bucks real quick. Let me go stand in line for a few hours and I'll flip it online. So, I mean, I thought that sending the cards to the store would be better. I still think it's better. I think more gamers actually got their hands on the cards. But essentially, the GPU pricing, according to WCCF Tech, is starting to go in an upward trend. And that's something that was kind of to be expected. Crypto's starting to make another rise or surge again. So anytime that happens, people start mining more. And when they start mining more, on top of the fact that what I just read the other day in passing, I didn't go too in depth in the article, is that the 3060s LHR had been reversed, right? So they figured out a way to get more hash rate out of it. Same with the 3080. So I have a 3080 and it's supposed to be about 50% of the hash rate of the non-LHR model. So it's supposed to be just not something that, not scalpers, but not something that miners would want to go after. But because, you know, they went around and they figured out a way to get up to 70% of that hash rate back, right? So instead of, or have it be 70% hash rate. So instead of, you know, being at 50%, now it's 70%, and now it's a more viable option for those people that want to mine. But you have that as a factor. You have the fact that mining is, or crypto is starting to go up again as a factor, which it could crash all over again, or it could, you know, drop and maybe we'll see a shift again. I would recommend, if you were trying to get a GPU, the best things you could do right now is go for a pre-built, right? So this is something I recommended in the past, but you can go through and you can find yourself a decent pre-build for anywhere between $1,200 and $1,500 in the US. Now, I would recommend those because they typically will have 3060, 3060 Ti's, and even sometimes you can get some lesser parts, like some trade-offs, right? Like a really small NVMe, maybe only a 1 terabyte spinning drive, and it'll be a 3070, but then you'll be in that $1,500, $1,600 range. So I've seen some deals like that. I've also seen some horrendous prices, so I'm not just saying go out and just randomly buy a pre-build, because I've seen some prices that are like 3070s or 3060 Ti's for like $2,000, and that's just not worth it. You might as well just buy the card on Facebook Marketplace for like $800, or on eBay for like $800 or $700 if you get a deal for the 3060 Ti, and then just build the rest of your PC yourself and have more control over all the components. So that's the way I would look at it. But if you're in the market for a GPU, prices are going up, and the best way to get one right now is going to be through getting a pre-build. Or if you do happen to get lucky, if you live near a micro center or one of those shops that do sell GPUs, there has been an uptick in availability, so that's a really big plus. It's not fixed yet, and the AMD ones are hella overpriced. So if you're into AMD, I don't understand how they're trying to sell a 6700 XT for like $900. That just blows my mind. It blows my mind. Granted, to last generation's performance, it might be good, but in today's day and age, like, the ones that are blowing it away are significantly less, especially the MSRP, which we really haven't seen too many GPUs in. But the AMD market is actually the worst when it comes to the increase in price as opposed to the announced MSRP. Like, you got cards that were supposed to be 480 selling for 900, and that's the actual MSRP of the card. So like, if you were to walk into a Best Buy and be able to buy one, not even scout, which is nuts. But that's all I got. Hopefully you all enjoyed this news update. Let me know if you like this format of video, just trying to get engaged with y'all and kind of share some of the knowledge that I have and pass it along to y'all. So hopefully this helped for some of y'all that really aren't in tune with the GPU market or are looking forward to Battlefield 2042. I'll catch y'all in the next video. Be easy.